Hello everybody, welcome to my fun channel. Today we are just about to open the market, and as you can see, Ethereum is like very bullish. I mean, back again on track for the bull run. I mean, you can see here was some correction lately, and now it's taking off again. The other Bitcoin and Dogecoin, for example, Dogecoin is not performing as good as Ethereum and Bitcoin. I mean, as you can see, there was like the correction, and since then it's almost flat. Bitcoin is doing like slightly better. So there was like this correction, and now it's coming back. I basically used this opportunity to transfer Tesla shares back and forth between Bitcoin, and made some profits here and there. I mean, it's just 1 minute to start for the market to open. Very curious what's going to happen with Tesla. So we will see when the market opens. If this is positive, maybe I can switch back again, share the Bitcoin, the Tesla shares, sell some Tesla shares and buy some Bitcoin. So this is what I was actually doing the last time. I bought like Tesla. I mean, I sold Tesla, sold Bitcoin, sold Ethereum, sold Bitcoin, and so on. Tesla and some Dogecoin as well. And I actually also put some fresh money in just to buy on this dip. So like I sold Ethereum, and all the time I invested the money, so I have no cash position in the moment. As you can see, it's all zero. I'm all in the moment, so I hope there's no black swan coming ahead now. Greetings to Ray Dalio, who's actually like talking about this black swan event since I think beginning of the year or almost longer. So there are a lot of people, like these people who like prophets, who see the crash coming, but they see the crash coming all the time. So when the crash comes, they are right, because they are just telling us that the crash is coming. You know, like if I tell every day the crash is coming, and tomorrow the crash is coming, or let's say tell it like for weeks and weeks, or every day, and after like 1 month the crash is coming, I say told you so, but in the end it's actually just say I'm just not predicting the crash. I'm just like repeating myself over and over again, and it's almost ridiculous in my opinion. So it's really hard to foresee the crash, or how to foresee the market. I mean, you can speculate. I think in the long run it's likely, let's say it that way, it's likely that technology will like make the profits higher. Companies reduce the costs, the profits get higher, the GDP gets of the country gets is increasing. You can, there are graphs, you can look it up, like compare the GDP of the US and with like today and 10 years ago, you see like there's an exponential curve. So the profits, like enterprise, get more valued because of this. This explains actually why the stocks are raising. I'm not sure if this is like valid information now. Sometimes there's a bug no, here it is. So it's negative. Ah, that's not so good, because I was hoping that I can profit on some of this Tesla shares and put it into Bitcoin, but actually Tesla is going down. So this might be related to the very negative wind from the Biden administration, which is like basically just mobbing the key driver company for electric vehicles, and like giving the credits to the ICE vehicle producers, just because they, I don't know the reason, but I would say they get a lot of support from the lobby, from the ICE lobby, like combustion engine lobby. So that might explain why we have here some negative like backwind. So it was looking fine. I mean, the stock was going up quite a lot, you know. Like, I mean, I have like I was investing here. I was taking advantage of this lows here at around 550, and since then it's like grown very good. And there's like some solid. You see, like there's a story here, you know. Like you see, this makes sense. I mean, if you are into charts, you see, like here basically you have like more or less a continuous growth story. I think it will continue. I cannot really estimate how much the stock will be worth in 10 years. It's very hard to predict, but I'm very, very confident that it will be much higher than it is now. So that's why I'm actually all in on Tesla. I mean, I'm not all in, but you see like my biggest position here on Tesla. So I'm already like almost 20% like profits here. This is incredible when you if you consider when I actually started to invest. I mean, I invested my first position. You can in eToro. I can make some advertisement for eToro. I'm not getting any like financial support from eToro. I just like the tool, so why not giving it some credit? So you can sort here the day the positions by day. So the 1st of June I actually started buying. Is this correct? 1st of June? So that makes sense here. So until September I started buying. 4th of June, I mean, come on, this is no, actually I have more positions, you see, since February. I was like since February, so half year. I mean, I'm investing since continuously investing in Tesla since half a year, and it's like growing very well. You see, like my position here is like from half a year is like 7% because it was like dipping very hard. And during the dip here, you see, I doubled down, even went in with 10K. I have 30% on this position. I mean, this is incredible. I like this company very much. I mean, you don't know what happened. Like, as you know, this guy, what's his name, this short seller, Michael Burry, who predicted the house market crisis and was like making a fortune for the investors, which still are angry at him because he did like cause them probably some gray hair by this unconventional investment method. He's actually predicting, like he's actually shorting Tesla. Can you imagine? Don't bet against Tesla. Don't bet against Elon, especially not against Tesla, but don't bet against Elon. That was actually the lesson we took like from last year. All this Gordon Johnsons and Mark, don't know the names anymore. All these short sellers got burnt. They got burnt to ground. And I mean, it's very risky for Michael Burry to go in, but maybe he's right. Maybe he has like a crystal ball and sees into the future. Like maybe on the short term there will be a black swan event. Interest will rise, and like there will be a financial crisis, and growth stocks like Tesla will get like very difficult times. But I mean, is Tesla really a growth stock? I mean, it's a growth stock, but look at its evaluation and its balance sheet. Tesla, it's a cash machine. I mean, it's not like depending on money anymore. I mean, it has too much money. It's buying Bitcoin. Seriously? So far to short Tesla, I don't think it's a good idea. As you can see here, I have a position around like $5,000. It was around $4,000. I was just like swing trading. I have a video about swing trading. Like I was swing trading all the time. I was swing trading the between Bitcoin, because I mean, I believe Bitcoin will be worth like a lot of money. I don't know if it's 100,000 or 1 million or 10 million, whatever prediction you want to pick, but I think it will be worth a lot of money because it's like incredible technology. This is the future, believe me. This is like there's no way around it. There will be regulations, and in the short term or like midterm, like the price will get hit. I mean, definitely. Don't go all in on this Bitcoin thing now. I mean, you see the growth is like insane over the like 2 or 3 years. Like 10x or whatever. So if you go in all in now, it's very likely that you get burned. So I would like go in a little bit, and maybe when you have a dip, when the Bitcoin is dipping, like it that did now, for example, or like 1 month ago, then you can like put in little bit more. You know, don't go with all your life savings into one stock at one time. You know, this is insane. Don't do that. Just do it like with small chunks. And if you believe a story like Bitcoin or Tesla, just put in some money. You know, like put in $100. You know, put your feet into the water, check if it's cold or hot. You know, get acquainted with the market, get used to your emotions, and it's very likely that you get like otherwise you get burnt. You know, we don't want that. You know, it's not a nice feeling. So this is my position. I just swing trading this position like between Bitcoin and Tesla because I'm convinced by the long-term story, but both I say ideologies or companies or cryptocurrencies, whatever you like. So I think this is going up. So if one dips, and the other one goes up, I just sell the one which went up and buy the one which dipped. You know, it's like it's funny. So I benefit on the long story, but I also benefit on the dips and on the short story. I mean, I haven't thought this like through, but in the moment it's working quite well. So this time it was like the other way around. So Bitcoin was going up and Tesla's was going down, so I cannot benefit on the dip. But okay, I'm not always right and I don't always have the opportunity, but if I get the opportunity, I'm using it. So that's the story about this. So let's go back to the watch list. What's going on the market? You can see Tesla's dipping again 1%. I mean, it's not like really bad if you consider like yeah it went here almost to back to 700, so it's like consolidating like on a like short-term high, I would say around here. So long-term high is still at $900. I think we will break through this long-term high soon, but today, not today, as you can see, we are negative. So I actually could benefit on this. So I could think about what can I sell. Look, Palantir is going up. Don't know why Palantir is going up. I like Palantir quite a lot. I was investing in Palantir almost like this was my second biggest position. But look at what happened then. I mean, I went in like I didn't make a loss, so I went in here like very early, and then doubled down, and then it's just flat. So you could like argue like there happened a lot so in the time like in 1 year period, so it's going to break out, can happen, but I don't want to wait for it. If you consider like Tesla, should I buy Tesla or Palantir? I sold all my Palantir and went into Tesla, which is obviously the bigger AI company in my opinion. It's not an automotive company anymore. Look at the AI day. Didn't that convince you? I mean, I was convinced. They're building robots and they're building autonomous driving. What is Palantir doing? I mean, Palantir is also like doing tough problems, solving tough problems, and like analyzing data and making machine learning algorithms benefit using it. But it's I don't think we will see like moon stuff, but it's going up, so maybe I'm wrong. So I could actually benefit on this. So my position is I broke even yesterday, so I'm 3% in plus with my position. So I could actually get rid of all my position and put it into Tesla, which what I should do. You know, it's like I have here some bucks, get them out, get out of Palantir. I have no Palantir anymore. Great. I mean, I had like this was my second most biggest position, and now I'm all out. So what should I do with the money? Have you listened to my story? So basically, I'm benefiting from the short term dip at Tesla, or I could look at other opportunities. Look, Coinbase. I mean, this is like cheap opportunity. Look at CRISPR. CRISPR is a cheap opportunity. It's going down again. I mean, it's incredible. You have so many cheap opportunities to buy in now. So I could actually like do a little bit here, do a little bit here. Like Zoom, this is like bargain shopping. So I start with Zoom, put $100 here. But actually I should start with Tesla. So I start with Tesla. I put 100, 167. So let's see what stays. Putting in, great. So CRISPR, I like CRISPR. I buy some CRISPR. Why not? Like put in $100. So increasing my position here. Coinbase, I love Coinbase. I mean, I'm using it. It's definitely undervalued. I mean, it gets a lot of pressure from the regulation department, but the story hasn't changed. I mean, if you sign up for Coinbase, I will like share actually a link where you can benefit $10 by buying $100 of Bitcoin, and I can benefit by this transaction as well if you register. So I put in a link at that in the below, so you can actually check out Coinbase yourself. I mean, it's very. I mean, I'm not getting any let's say benefits from Coinbase, but I like it. I mean, it's good web interface. It's working. It's solid. It's secure. I have the feeling it's secure. So even if you are located in Germany, the BaFin is actually backing it up. So also, it's using like this two-way security communication system, which is like more secure than just putting in the password. So I like the Coinbase thing. Actually, it works. So what else should I buy? I have $100 left. I could buy Teladoc. I mean, I haven't followed up on Teladoc quite a while. So, or like get some Chinese stock. Look at this. It's like cheap. But actually, I don't buy Chinese stuff in the moment. I don't like the Chinese government, what it's doing and to the companies, and like squeezing like the Western squeezing the Western investors. You know, I'm happy I went all out from Tencent. I mean, Tencent completely get beaten. I mean, Alibaba got beaten. I mean, Baidu got beaten. I bought some Baidu lately, but I don't know. What do you think about Chinese stock? I don't feel confident that this is really like a working like economy. I mean, like the Western economy is not working either so well, but it's working somehow more or less. So there are like a lot of regulation and like constraints. You see like Tesla, how much problems they make for this incredible company. They're creating problems. You see like this is, I mean, there are similarities to like totalitarian, like, or let's say authoritarian government in China. There are like similarities. They're like people in power which don't like it if you take their lunch, eat your lunch, their lunch. You know, they don't like if you eat their breakfast, their lunch, and their dinner at the same time. That's what Tesla are doing. So they're getting a lot of trouble. The same will be probably happen for Bitcoin because all the financial institutions, what they're going to do. I mean, they are completely useless, obviously. If Bitcoin is working like on a bigger scale, what can they provide to the human being in the society anymore? Just like, is that, I mean, I don't want to be like negative, but this is really, they're eating their lunch as well. So all the bankers and central banks and all this system is not like cannot compete with a decentralized automatic system with smart contracts where transactions happen in 30 minutes. I mean, I'm using this stuff myself. It's incredible. It's working. It's fun. I like it. I can send money around wherever I want. Nobody has to approve it. I mean, okay, now they'd say, oh, this will be used for criminal activity. Yeah, okay, dollars are also used for criminal activity. How do you think a pimp is paying their prostitutes? I mean, do you think they pay them with bread? No, it's with money. So if you want to do something against criminality, do something against criminality. Don't do something about the tools they are using. Also, criminals use Smartphones. Do you go after smartphones there? I mean, it doesn't make any sense, you know. But anyway, I shouldn't get. I'm a bit emotional today, so don't take this for granted. I still have $100 left. What should I do with this $100? I mean, look at Dogecoin. It's like it's diving deep. I mean, I went in on Dogecoin quite a lot. I think this Dogecoin thing is more than a meme stock, and I dig a bit deeper. So the transaction fees are quite good, and there's coming an upgrade. So I don't understand this negative. This negative. I mean, also Ethereum is losing their profits today. So Cardano anyway, but you know my opinion about Cardano. But Palantir, look at this growth. I mean, maybe I did a mistake selling everything. Oops. Let's have a look at my Dogecoin position. Ui, Dogecoin position, not so good. Oh, a lot of losses here. What have I done? So now I'm not buying any Dogecoin anymore. I mean, just nothing against eToro. You know I like eToro, but look at how much they want, like 3% for my, if I put in like $100, they want 3% just for the spread. It's too much. In a moment, like I don't want to put in. I think, I mean, look at my position at Dogecoin. It's like $7,000, so it's quite a risky investment, so I keep it that way. So look at Teladoc. I just bought Teladoc. Like, is it today? Like 50, no, so didn't I buy Teladoc? Huh, just thought I bought Teladoc. I have to play check the replay. Yeah, anyway, I could buy Teladoc. I could buy Zoom, a bit more Zoom. Look like CRISPR's like it's my worst position. I mean, let's buy some CRISPR. Let's buy some more CRISPR. I'm positive here. From yesterday, my position from yesterday is positive. But look at my losses here as well. It's incredible. And here I did the mistake. I went in like a big chunk very early. My first position, $1,000, 30% loss. I mean, can you imagine that? Bad mistake. Don't do that. So what else do we have here? What can I buy with 100 bucks? I could buy some Bitcoin, more Tesla. I don't know. What else? NIO. I don't know. Why should I buy NIO if there's like Tesla? Not much I can consider in the moment. So maybe I watch like look at Tesla's like go diving a little bit. So just leave it. I don't have I have a little cash position here. Fair enough. So let's see what today brings. That's my little dive into the market today. I think I overdid it anyway. I lost probably 100% of the people who were just listening for 30 seconds. So anyway, if you stayed in so long, thank you very much for your attention. I appreciate a lot. And don't take this as investment advice. I'm just having fun and just brainstorming what comes to my mind. So don't take this as professional investment advice, just for entertainment and for me for training purposes. So stay healthy and stay tuned. See you in the next video.